Good evening. Well, I just got in from shopping with my granddaughter, Caitlin, and she is excited because she gets to take her driver's test on, I think, January the 10th. So she wants to get in some driving, so at night driving. So she said, Granny, can we go shopping and let me drive? And I said, sure. So we just got back. It is the third day of the 12 days of Christmas. And are you ready? I'm ready. It gets busy this time of year, doesn't it? But we're going to steal away and find the time to do what God has told me to do. If you will turn to the first book of Luke, chapter 1. And we are going to start on the verse 30 through 35. And it says here in the word, And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. And he shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How can this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also the holy thing which thou hast born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Wow. On over in that chapter, she tells the angel, Be it unto me. Okay, Mary knows now that she's pregnant. She has to tell Joseph. I don't think she was excited about that. And of course, we've already talked about how Joseph must have felt. But she had to wait. She had to wait patiently, just like my granddaughter is waiting to take that exam so she can drive a car. She had to wait. Sometimes we have to wait on things that we don't understand. We don't understand what's going on, but let's wait. God can work everything out if we just trust him. But I'm going to share a song with you, and we're going to take you way back to that stable, to that cold winter's night. And it's titled, The Labor of Love. And I know all this would sound better with a PA system, but you know what? Maybe later in the week, but I just feel like I need to do it like this.
It was not a silent night. There was blood on the ground. And you could hear a woman cry in the alleyway that night on the streets of David's town. And the cobblestones were cold, and the stable was not clean, and little Mary, full of grace, with the tears upon her face, had no mother's hand to hold. It was a labor of pain. It was a cold sky above. But for the girl on the ground in the dark, every beat of her beautiful heart was a labor of love. Noble Joseph by her side, calloused hands and weary eyes. There was no midwife to be found, on the streets of David's town, in the middle of the night. So he held her and he prayed. Shafts of moonlight on her face, for the baby in the womb, he was the maker of that moon. He was the author of our faith that can make the mountains move. It was a labor of pain. It was a cold sky of love. But for the girl on the ground in the dark, every beat of her beautiful heart, it was a labor of love. Little Mary, full of grace, with the tears upon her face, was a labor of love. It was not a silent night on the streets of David's town. What a night, my friends. The night that Mary gave birth to our Savior. Wow. I love the part. I've written a lot of songs, and I love how the writer talked about Joseph's calloused hands. You know, he was a carpenter, and he worked hard to provide for his family. He didn't leave it out. And I especially like the part that he is the maker of that same moon that shone down on her face that night. Wow, what a song. But my friends, what a Savior. The night in Bethlehem when our Savior was born in that lonely stable in a manger. This was day 3 of the 12 days of Christmas. God bless you. Good night. We'll see you tomorrow, Lord's willing.